Sarah and welcome to Kiwi Fern Immigration Services. My name is Aparna Prakash and I'm a licensed immigration advisor. Today we're going to talk about the roles that are offered for an essential skills work visa. So the tip of the week is the positions being offered in an essential skills work visa. In this video, we're going to talk about what position is the right position for you when you are applying for an essential skills work visa. Often I get asked in a phone call that I have been offered the role of an assistant shift manager or a night field manager or an IT manager. Would this role be correct for me? It's extremely difficult for an immigration advisor or a lawyer to answer these calls on or just answer this question on just a phone call, because there are lots of factors that determine whether this position that you've been offered is the right one for you or not. So I'm going to talk about a few factors today, which you can think about next time before making a phone call. The first thing that you need to think about is the ANZSCO tasks or the code for that position. Whether the position that has been offered to you, whether the job description actually matches the ANZSCO tasks, and whether the qualifications that is mentioned in the ANZSCO task is the qualification that you possess. That's the first one. So therefore, when we are saying an assistant night field manager or a shift manager, assistant shift manager, is not the same as a store manager, because the ANZSCO tasks are probably not going to match. So an assistant shift manager would be categorized as a retail supervisor and probably get only a one-year work visa. The other point that we are going to talk about is the organizational chart. So organizational chart is a very important factor in determining whether you're in charge of a place. You may have one person working under you, or you may have more than one person, maybe two or three people working under you. But are you responsible for recruiting, selecting, and training those people? That's what is important. The next factor that we're going to talk about is the compliance of an employer. That plays a huge role as well, whether you get granted a visa or not. The employer has to be compliant with all immigration laws and employment laws. And that can be checked from the immigration website. Last but not the least is the sustainability of a business. The business that has offered you the role, is the business a sustainable one? Bear in mind, the amount of sales in a particular week or a month for a company does not determine that the company or the employer is a very sustainable one. So it is good to check before you apply for a visa whether that factor is also covered. So that's the tip of the week for choosing the right position for an essential skills work visa. So if you are in doubt, you may want to go through these factors yourself and see whether the ANZSCO, the qualification, the org chart, and the compliance of the employer and the sustainability of the business, all of those factors are taken into consideration. You may have to, like to go through it yourself. Alternatively, you can book an appointment with any advisor or lawyer and find out if the position is right for you. Definitely not just on a phone call. If you like this video or if you're in doubt, please leave a comment below and I'm happy to answer any questions that you may have. Thank you for watching.